a new vaccine to prevent pneumonia from causing dangerous complications in adults. And here to talk about that is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Good to see you, Doctor.
Hey, Dr. T. Great to see you. So question one. As you know, pneumonia is very serious, and in some cases even deadly. For about 1 million Americans every year, other than childbirth, by the way, it's the most common reason why adults are hospitalized in the United States, which is really an amazing statistic. But we already have a few vaccines that are available for pneumonia. So how is this one different?
Well, this is different because it's expanding the number of types of strains that are in this vaccine. So prior, we used to have 13 and then 15 and 20. This vaccine now has 21 different serotypes, and it's the vaccine that contains the most number of serotypes for these type of conjugated vaccines that protect against the most number of strains that cause invasive pneumococcal disease, not just pneumonia, mm-hmm. but pneumonia when you have the bacteria in your blood as well, or pneumonia when you have meningitis, things like that. So I think it's a real iterative improvement. Remember, it was just FDA approved last week. We're waiting on the CDC to see what their recommendations are.
How do you decide who needs which shot and when do they need it?
Right. Well, Maria, great question. And we're going to learn that from the CDC this Thursday. Hopefully they'll vote on it. But in the past, it's been extremes of age, the elderly, so 65 and older, and then those adults that are 18 and older who have chronic medical conditions like chronic heart, chronic lung disease, kidney, and immunocompromised states. If you're on chemotherapy with cancer, or if you have splenectomy, and there are other comorbidities as well.
So Dr. T, I'm curious. Could and the key word in the sentence is could this new shot replace what's already out there, at least for some people?
Right, so it definitely could, and it's the broadest range right now for pneumococcal vaccines that are conjugated. Remember, these trials didn't go head-to-head, so we can't say this is better than the other ones before, but I think, you know, what we're seeing is scientific progress. One thing I do want to say, Eddie, is that two-thirds of patients 65 and older have received a pneumococcal vaccine in the past, but there's still a gap. And there's even a wider gap for those adults 18 to 64 with those chronic medical conditions. Most of those adults have not received a pneumococcal vaccine. So I want people to consider this vaccine, but more important than which vaccine you choose, get something. There are good pneumonia vaccines out there to help prevent a serious disease.
All right, Dr. Todd Ellerin, thank you so much, Doctor.
Great
talking
to you. Take care.